At the end of the topic, you will be able to explain the meaning of human rights and its different rights, enumerate the functions of the Human Rights Commission, examine the priorities and powers of the National Human Rights Commission. Human beings can have a satisfied life only if they are given some rights in the society. The rights given to them are called as human rights. According to Boesen-Kent, a right is a claim recognized by a society and enforced by the state. It shapes human beings to have all-round development in the society. Human rights are the social and economic rights of man. The UNO has taken special measures to protect human rights, especially after the Second World War. Every year, 24th October is celebrated as UNO Day. UNO is an international organization. It has powers to enforce international law, security, economic development, and social peace. The United Nations officially came into existence on 24th October 1945. The purpose of the existence of the United Nations is to work for the peace and development of all nations. Its principles are based on justice, human dignity, and the well-being of all people. Its headquarters is located at New York City, and it has 193 members. The UN Declaration of Human Rights. The United Nations was established on 24th October 1945. The objective of the United Nations organization is to protect and respect the human rights. To frame the principles of human rights, a commission was established. An International Bill on Human Rights was drafted. This international bill was adopted by the United Nations. It was adopted by the General Assembly on 10th December 1948. It is called the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. Equality to all human beings is emphasized by UNO. It consists of 30 articles. They are divided into civil and political rights, socio-economic and cultural rights. Universal Declaration of Human Rights. On 10th December 1948, the Universal Declaration of Human Rights was adopted by the UN General Assembly at Paris as an impact of the Second World War. It guaranteed the rights of every human being everywhere. It was the first global expression of rights of every human being, civil and political rights. Civil and political rights evolves from the international human rights. Civil rights means rights of a citizen. This is the first rights to be recognized. It is a right of an individual by virtue of being a citizen. Political rights means rights to political participation, right to vote, right to stand as a candidate, the right to join a political party, etc. The rights. The rights includes the following: freedom to life, liberty, and security of a person, freedom from slavery and all tortures, equality before law, freedom to own property, freedom to political participation, freedom to marry, social protection of all children, special care to motherhood and childhood. The socio-economic and cultural rights. The socio-economic and cultural rights include right to work, right to get equal work and equal pay, right in forming trade unions and joining them, right to have a good standard of living, right to education, freedom to participate in cultural activities. Protection of human rights. The Universal Declaration of Human Rights is to be enforced in all nations. To protect human rights, the UNO has adopted two covenants on 16th December 1966. International Covenant on Economic, Social and Cultural Rights, ICESCR, the International Covenant on Civil and Political Rights, ICCPR. The above covenants are legally binding on the states. The members of the UNO have to promote and respect human rights. Human Rights World Conference was held at Vienna in 1993. It adopted the Vienna Declaration and Programs of Action. To promote and protect all human rights is the vital concern of the international community. The Government of India passed an act in 1993. The Act specifies setting up a National Human Rights Commission at New Delhi. The states drafted the State Human Rights Commissions to protect and promote the human rights of the people. National Human Rights Commission. The National Human Rights Commission came into existence on 12th October 1993. The body of the NHRC consists of a chairperson and four members. A retired Chief Justice of the Supreme Court is usually appointed as the chairperson. The four members consist of a retired judge of the Supreme Court, a retired Chief Justice of a High Court, and two members who possess practical knowledge and experience in human rights. They are appointed by the President. Composition. The headquarters of the National Human Rights Commission is at New Delhi. The members of the Commission can be appointed or removed from their position only by the President. The term of office for the chairperson is 5 years or 70 years. The term of office for other members is also 5 years. They can be reappointed for another term of 5 years. Functions of the Commission. The main aim of the National Human Rights Commission is to protect the human rights. They perform various functions. They are as follows. To encourage and undertake research in the field of human rights. To conduct seminars and through media spread awareness of human rights among various sections of the society. To act on petitions presented to it by the victim or any person on his behalf. The National Human Rights Commission has given priority to protect the civil liberties, to examine the legislations which are against human rights principles, to eliminate custodial violence and rape, redressal of human rights grievances of scheduled castes and scheduled tribes, women and children. Powers.
The National Human Rights Commission plays a vital role in protecting the rights of the public. The powers of civil court under civil procedure are also enjoyed by the Commission. The Commission has to submit its annual report to the concerned government. The government shall lay its petition before each House of Parliament and the memorandum of action taken or going to be taken on the recommendation of the Commission.
In this topic, you have learnt human rights with special reference to civil and political rights and socio-economic and cultural rights, the structure of the National Human Rights Commission and its functions. Explain the role played by the National Human Rights Commission. At the end of the topic, you will be able to explain the meaning of State Human Rights Commission and its function, write about women's rights and its different associations, point out the various articles on child rights and the role of UNO. State Human Rights Commission. State Human Rights Commission was established on 17th April 1997. The State Human Rights Commission consists of five members. They are a retired Chief Justice as chairperson, a retired judge of the High Court, a retired person or a person who is in service as a district judge of the state, two members who have practical knowledge or experience in matters related to human rights. The secretary is the chief executive officer of the State Human Rights Commission. For Tamil Nadu, the headquarters is located at Chennai. Under Part 3 of the Indian Constitution, the Commission inquires into the violations of human rights. The members of the State Human Rights Commission are appointed by the Governor on the recommendation of the committee. The committee consists of the Chief Minister, Speaker of the Legislative Assembly, Minister in charge of the Home Department in the state, and the Leader of the Opposition in the Legislative Assembly. Members of the SHRC can be removed from office by the Governor if they are proved of misconduct. The term of office is 5 years or 70 years of age, whichever is earlier for all members. Functions of the SHRC. The SHRC has to submit its annual report to the state government. The report contains the work completed and recommended for the protection of human rights. The state government has to submit the report before each house of the state legislature for taking the next step. The Social Justice and Human Rights Wings enforce Prevention of Atrocities Act. There are four special courts located at Trichy, Tanjavur, Madurai and Tirunelveli to try cases on POA Act at district level in Tamil Nadu. Women's Rights. To raise the status of women and remove the injustices against women, the Government of India has passed much legislation. They are as follows. To legalize the widow remarriage, the Hindu Remarriage Act was passed in 1856. The Hindu Marriage Act of 1955 states that the marriageable age for women is 21. For women to inherit their parental property, the Hindu Succession Act of 1956 was passed. To provide justice for those women who unjustly suffered in the name of dowry, the Dowry Prohibition Act was passed in 1961. To prohibit the indecent representation of women in magazines, newspapers, etc., Independent Representation Act was passed in the year 1999 by the Tamil Nadu government. To relieve women of harassment, the eve-teasing law was passed in 1997. Thus, the government has taken all efforts to uplift women from their downtrodden position. Labor legislation for women. In this modern world where women workers are equal in number in all sectors, they need protection at their place of work. For the protection of women workers, several laws were passed by the Government of India. Some of the acts passed by the Government of India are the Factory Act of 1948, the Plantation Labor Act of 1951, the Mines Act of 1952. They were passed to protect and regulate the wages of women without discrimination. They were also given privileges through the Maternity Benefit Act of 1961, assuring maternity leave to pregnant women with pay. To recognize women's role in the family and society, every year 8th March is celebrated as International Women's Day. Eminent Women Personalities. A women's conference was held at Beijing, the capital of China, in the year 1995. Women from all over the world attended the conference. The message was, women's rights are human rights and human rights are women's rights. United Nations Organization recognizing women's role in the society declared 1978 as the International Year of Women. Women's Association. Women felt that there was need to form associations to fight for their rights. Women's associations like Democratic Women's Association and the Pen Urumai Iyakam in Tamil Nadu are working for the welfare of women. The non-government voluntary organizations like the Lions Club, Rotary Club and Inner Wheel Club are working for the development of women. Child's rights. The Constitution of India has formed certain articles for the protection of the rights of children against all kinds of exploitations. Some of the articles are as follows. Article 39F, for the healthy development of children and to provide all facilities. Article 45 states that all state governments must provide free and compulsory education for all children till the age of 14. Article 24 prohibits child labor. According to the Juvenile Injustice Act of 1986, it protects children who are deprived of adequate care and they also help reform children. All these legislations passed by the Government of India have not solved the child labour problems. Constant appeals are made through the medias like Doordarshan, radio, newspapers and magazines to put an end to child labour. Government has undertaken all awareness programs appealing to parents to send their children to school. The world can progress only when human rights are protected at all costs with the support of the government and the people. 1979 was declared as the International Year of Children by the UN. In this topic, you have learned the State Human Rights Commission, its functions and its impact on the society. The Government of India has passed much legislation for the welfare of women in the country. Women's associations and eminent women personalities are doing their best to establish human rights. Much legislation has been passed for the protection of child rights.